Trafficking in India and throughout the world has its roots in economic disempowerment. And certainly when we're talking about sex trafficking, it has its roots in the low status of women.
The value of a girl was not the same as that of a boy. And the opportunities given to a girl were not the same as that given to the boys.
When women have no other opportunities, when girls are not valued in their homes, when they're not given an education, and they just become a commodity.
Women are getting abused at home, at the workplace, where they are living. We are talking about giving them equal status and right, but we are failing to give them.
When I found out that there were just millions and millions of men and women and children who were living in slavery, and that so many of them were young girls, just the most vulnerable people who'd already been so marginalized and so poor, and it made them vulnerable, and they were being sold at such a young age into brothels and suffering unimaginable torture and abuse and dehumanization. And that even after all that, getting rescued, many of them were being rejected by their families, blamed for what was done to them, outcast from society, and were just destined to really keep repeating the cycle of exploitation because of those issues. I was absolutely compelled to do something about it.
Each year, I have been working with 400 to 500 children, and that is quite a large number. When they come to us, they are actually in a state of very delicate health.
So from the very beginning, our focus was on long-term interventions that would truly allow them to be slavery-proof and allow them to become and to remain free forever.
We had about 100 girls. They have different age from 5 to like 17, 18.
When girls are rescued at a young age, like 12 or 13, often it's possible for them to reintegrate into society through education and just to go back to a normal school. But many times when girls are rescued in 16, 18, or in their 20s, and they may have never even have been to kindergarten, it's really hard for them to go back. And sometimes they don't want to. They may have a baby, or they just may be at that point in their life where they want to stand on their own feet and be independent. So for those girls, jobs really are the best option.
And over time, we saw the need for higher wage employment, which would really allow people to get way above the poverty line, and that they would then be able to really change their entire communities and families from within, and that both they and their children would be able to be free forever through their independence and through their self-direction and supporting themselves. We started the jewelry program in 2010, and we've really seen lives change, like an arc of girls' lives, from seeing them when they were first rescued and in a shelter home and dealing with a tremendous amount of trauma, through the healing process, becoming self-employed and gaining self-respect and self-esteem, and then moving out of the shelter home, becoming independent, and then paying it forward, the final step, where they really become a change maker in their family and community.
Her future is making India's future better.
In Indian culture, always men are doing jewelry. They never allow girls to make jewelry. But this is the first time Heart Future Coalition offered them to make jewelry to girls.
And they are staying above the poverty line, making jewelry as a result of the program that was created by Sarah.
It's a family. Whenever I am depressed, they're helping me. Whenever they're depressed, we are helping them. It's like a family. We don't need outside people or our own family. We are happy here.
A lot of the young women that we've trained in jewelry also have a passion for design. And they have a lot to say through their art and through their jewelry.
When they will learn how to make jewelry, they can earn money, but at the same time, they can share their pain through jewelry as their design inspirations.
I get inspiration by nature.
রাস্তাঘাটে যতগুলো বাস গাড়ি এসব এগুলো যাওয়া আসে
আমি পাতা দিয়ে
আইডিয়া বের করি, যত সুন্দর সুন্দর পাতা রাস্তাঘাটে দেখতে পাই, সবুজ সবুজ ছোট ছোট ওই পাতা দিয়ে আমি আইডিয়া বের করার চেষ্টা করি, কিন্তু হয় না। আমি ভালো ড্রয়িং পারি না, তার জন্য আমি খুব ট্রাই করি, মানে করতে 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 ভালো যখন হয় তখন মনে হয় বলে আমার এটা ভালো লাগছে আমার, তখন আমি রেখে দিই।
We hope to not only provide more opportunities for these young women, but for many others, and to spread awareness of this issue and to bring unity around the world where people are working together for women to rise up.
All of us, yeah. This is a journey.
A piece of jewelry that is ending slavery, and it's ending slavery in individual women's lives right now. It doesn't get any better than that.
It's a movement towards independence, towards equality, towards gender respect. And this is just one step in the right direction. Women are rising. Women are rising everywhere, but we have so much work to do. And if we're helping a handful of women reclaim their lives and have a future that is beautiful and hopeful, it's a pretty fabulous thing.
Uplifting women, ending slavery is everybody's responsibility. It's everybody's work. You know, it's not my work, it's not just the work of the people here. We all need to work together around the globe.
Our future can make more women's future independent, bright, progressive, and make their future just full of happiness.
So many of them are already training others. They're taking these skills and sharing them with newly rescued girls at a shelter home. Some of them have been involved in stopping trafficking in their own communities, in their own families. So for every one of them that you employ, you're helping 10 other people. And so I believe that they are going to be the end of this issue. They're going to take this forward and they're going to change the world. And so my job is just to continue to empower and support them. And I pray that by the end of my lifetime, or at least theirs, that this will no longer be a scourge on this planet Earth.
Our world, our woman's future will be very proud and get inspiration for others, make inspiration for others. Thank you.
Her future is limitless.
Her future is freedom.
Her future is faith.
Her future is happy.
Her future is getting self-respect.
Her future is beautiful.